戴马巴顿女士，福特校长，欧康诺副校长，威尔教授，贝尔女士，今天我们能在这个地方聚会，为世界和平祈祷。我承蒙大会的邀请，让我在这边讲几句话，我感觉得非常的荣幸，也祝福大家好。
Respected Chancellor, Griffin University, Ms. Lenine Boy, Vice Chancellor, Griffin University, Professor Ian O'Connor, Auntie Delma Huaju, Respected Indigenous Elder, Respected Archbishops and Bishops, Venerables and Clergy, Imam and leaders of diverse faiths and interfaith organizations, Professor Ken Wilshire, Chairman, Australian National Commission for UNESCO, Her Excellency Yati Rafiyanti Risa, Assistant Ambassador, Permanent Delegation to Indonesia, to UNESCO, Dr. Ari Rahman, Executive Chairman, Indonesian National Commission for UNESCO, Father Patrick McInerney, Representative of the Holy See, Vatican, TBC, Ms. Lu Fei, Council Chinese Consulate, Brisbane, Professor Azimari Azra Ratta, Sharif Hidayatua, State Islamic University, Indonesia, and other distinguished educators and peace builders from many countries. Professor Sharon Bell, Griffith University, Pro Vice Chancellor, Equity and Community Partnerships, and Professor To Sui Hien, Griffith University, Director of Multi-Faith Center, and all the distinguished participants and guests. It is an honor for me to be here today to pray for the world peace. And I want to thank the university and UNESCO to have me here.
今天我到大会来，看到我们中心杜教授提出来的这一次的议题内容啊，非常的丰富，我们看了很欢喜。
Today, when we come to come to the symposium, I saw the four topics that Professor To brought up that's very interesting for the symposium. And raise a lot of thoughts for us.
这一次我们讨论的主题是推动伦理道德教育，促进世界和平。
Today's topic is the importance of ethics and moral education in building world peace.
那么我在这之前准备了一篇讲演。这个讲演的已经用文字印出来了，我想会后会送给大家了，请大家多多的指教。
Today, actually, I've already prepared a speech, which is already being published and put into a booklet, and I believe that everybody already has a copy.
那么大会还是希望我上台啊，跟诸位啊，多少要说几句话，我也是义不容辞啊，所以今天我特地赶到此地来。
And then out of Professor To invited me, insisted that I should be here today and to be on stage and to say a few words in person.And I feel very obligated. That's something that I should be, I ought to do.
在这几个月当中，我也走了很多地方，环绕地球一周啊，也是有很深的感触，越发觉得这个和平安定 在现前社会当中是非常非常的迫切需要。
For the past few months, I have traveled to many places. Practically, I have traveled around the world. And during my travel, I particularly felt strongly that world peace and stability in our society is terribly needed right now.
宇宙的清净，国家民族的兴旺，家庭的和乐，人民的健康快乐，一切都是以教学为先，修身为本。
The purity of the universe, and the prosperity of a nation, the happiness and the harmony in the family, and the health of a person, all derives from that we have put the first priority into education and the cultivation of oneself.
在古老的中国，至少有5000年推动啊伦理道德教育的经验。
In China, for the past 5,000 years, its civilization is experienced in promoting the education on moral value teachings.
那么诸位都知道，中国有一位大教育家孔子啊，孔子距离我们现在大约有2500年。
We in China, we have a great educator. His name is Confucius, and he's was born 2,000 years ago.
那么我们从孔子留下来的这些书籍，他常常推崇赞叹中国更古老的圣贤呢，尧舜这两位帝王。
And from all the books that are left to us by Confucius, he mentioned that even more ancient teachings of the saints and sages of Emperor Yao and Emperor Shun.
那么尧舜距离孔子那个时候至少有2000年，所以这是在中国文字上记载的。那么这个中国传统的教育呢，至少有4500年。
And then from the books are recorded and talked and mentioned in Confucian teachings, that from the time in between Emperor Yao and Emperor Shun, there's already a span of 2,000 years. So in total, the Chinese civilization now is already over 4,500 years old.
那么这些所谓大圣大贤，他们呢都非常的谦虚，都说自己一生没有发明，没有创造。那么他所修学的就是他所教的，都是古圣先贤的教诲。那么由此可知，那至少在没有文字上记载，还可以上往上呢再推500年。那么这就是至少的时候，我们肯定啊，中国这个教育有5000年的历史。
So it is very definite that all the teachings of all the Confucian teachings can be traced back to all the ancient Chinese saint, the teachings of Chinese saints and sages. So it's we can safely say that the Chinese civilization now.
古圣先贤教育的内容我们一定要知道，他教我们什么，可以说综合起来的一共有3桩事情。好，这个中国教育的内容归纳起来至少有3桩事情。
There are three things you can sum up for the Chinese education.
那么第一桩呢，就是教我们呢知道人与人的关系。
The first is about the relationship between people.
第二桩呢是教导我们人与事的关系。这个事用现在的话来讲呢，就是我们这个世间呢许多的行业啊，各行各业呀、啊，跟我们生活的关系，这个要晓得。
And then the second relationship is the relationship between people and the external environment. Basically, would be the different professions of different people, and then their activities.
啊，那么第三呢，就是要我们了解人与天地万物的关系。
And then the third relationship is to understand the relationship between man and beings of different dimensions.
啊，综合起来说呢，这就是宇宙人生的真相。
And to sum it up, these are the facts about our universe.
啊，所以到尧舜时代，中国的教育已经纳入官方的体系了，所以政府设置有主管教育的官员。
So by the time the civilization has matured to the time of Emperor Yao and Emperor Shun, the educational system in China was already systematized.
那么他的教育的内容就是五伦跟这个八德。
And then the teaching of the education is about the five relationships, human relations, and also the eight virtues.
啊，五伦就是道，啊，八德是德，所以我们简单称的是道德的教育，伦理道德的教育。
And then, so to put it simply, the five relationships between people is really the way of nature, and then the eight virtues. The eight virtues. So this is what we call the moral teachings of the virtues.
那么伦理道德的教育啊，它有一个中心点，啊，这个中心点呢。就是五伦里面第一条所讲的父子有亲，这个亲就是亲爱，这个亲爱是天性的。
And then the center of the five human relationships, centered on the relationship between parents and children, because the relationship between parents and children are really the self nature of humankind.
所以伦理道德的教育简单说就是爱的教育。
So to put it simply, the moral education is really the education of love.
啊，那么这个人啊，爱的教育，这是天性的，这个就是道德。啊，那么怎么这个教育呢？如何能把这个爱的教育啊永恒地保持，让它不变质？然后再发扬光大，从父子的亲爱，扩展到家庭的亲爱，啊，你这个朋友的亲爱、社会的亲爱、国家的亲爱、对世界一切众生的亲爱，啊，这个是伦理道德教育的核心。
So the core of moral education, is to expand this love within the family.And to keep the loving relationship between parents and children intact. So eventually this love can be expanded throughout the family, into the society, into the nation, and also eventually throughout the world.
那么今天我们很多这个朋友啊，有老朋友也有新朋友啊，都是从事于教育工作的。那么宗教的这个领导人呢，也都是从事于社会教育的啊，所以我们非常的欢喜，非常肯定啊，诸位一同来参加这个会议啊， 希望能够对于化解冲突、促进世界和平呢，能有一点帮助啊。那么，这是我非常诚恳的来欢迎啊，欢迎诸位大德们来一起来参与这一项的会议啊，谢谢大家。
And then today I see many old friends and new friends. Religious education is the social education. And I am positive that we can all work together to help promote the topic of today's symposium, cultivating wisdom and fostering peace together.And I here welcome you all to attend the symposium.
好，谢谢。
Thank you.
校长啊，诸位大德们，这个刚才我也做了一个简单的提示啊，就是今天我们要想化解冲突、促进和平的。只有教育，除了教育之外，实在想不出更好的方法。
Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, and respected all the guests, distinguished guests. Just now, I made a very summarized.Talk introduction to today's topic. Today, if we want to promote world peace, I think that the only solution depends on education.
教育在中国确实是有很长的历史啊。这个累积着有丰富的经验与智慧啊，那么它的教育的内涵与教育的效果啊，一直都影响着中国人。
Education, the education in China does have a very long history.And has is very experienced, and it's highly effective.
那么这种这个教育的理念啊，以及教育的实施、教育的效果啊，我今年有机会到欧洲做了一次旅行，我们看到德国、英国、法国。啊，对于这个中国传统的教学啊，他们有很深的研究啊，也有很好的成果。我就参观了牛津大学跟伦敦大学的汉学中心。
I have the opportunity, like I mentioned before, that I have traveled quite extensively.And I have been to Germany, Britain, and France. And I've also visited Oxford University. And I found that they all have programs on Chinese civilization and culture.
那么中国这个教育有这么长的历史，它的教育中心啊，就是伦理道德。用现在的话来说。就是爱与和谐。
The core of Chinese education is on moral values teachings. In essence, it means love.
那么中国教育的特色，这是我们必须要知道的，它是在家庭，啊，古老的这中国这个前辈呀。他们看这个观察的非常清晰啊，看出来一个小孩从生下来，他睁开眼睛 他就会看，他就会听，他就在模仿，他就在接受教育。
The distinct feature of a Chinese education centers on family education. Children were closely watched and observed since childhood. And it's very important on the family education, on moral teachings.
所以在中国古籍记载的时候，这是中国人讲胎教啊，胎教是周文王的母亲啊，胎任，他的名字叫胎任啊，怀周文王的时候啊，那书籍里面记载啊，他的思想纯正啊，言不看不善的东西，耳不听不好的东西啊，说话没有傲慢，都柔和。这种起心动念呢，这个一举一动呢，他知道都影响胎儿。
So we can trace the education a good example historically. We can trace it back to Emperor Zhou Wenwang in the Zhou Dynasty. His mother, when she was pregnant with Zhou Wenwang, she paid special attention.Such as she only observed correct thing. She will not look at anything that's not properly done, and she will think correctly, and she only hear what is proper, and even on his thoughts, his actions would be very cautious, and she would not do anything.That would influence the child when the child is not yet born.
那么中国人承认的人性本善啊，所以你看，在这个同盟教学课本《三字经》啊，一开头就是“人之初，性本善”，啊，人为什么会变成不善呢？那就是接受不良的教育，啊，他慢慢的学坏了，啊，不是他的本性坏。本性都是善的，啊，都是好的，啊，这特别是我们从事于教育工作的人，一定要肯定，要以这个为基础，啊，人性本善，啊，那么在佛教里面，肯定啊，一切众生皆有佛性，这个意思都完全相同。
In the Chinese teaching, In the Confucian teachings, that it is taught that the self-nature of humankind originally would all good. The reason now it's no longer perfect and pure is due to the later education, or maybe more badly guided education.And then, of course, in Buddhism as well, it teaches that the human nature or the self nature of all beings are originally kind and good as well.
所以中国在伦理教育里面，除了这个父子有亲呢，这个亲爱是原点，另外一个重要就是。夫妇有别，啊，就是夫妻结合组成一个家庭，家庭是社会的基本的单位，啊，那么家庭分工，啊，所以这别就是夫妇他有不同的任务，啊，那么家庭最重要的呢，就两桩事情，一个是生活问题，所以男子出去谋生，啊，这个照顾家庭的经济生活。那个太太在家里啊，她最重要的一个任务啊，就是教小孩，啊，就是负责教育啊。所以说无后为大了，她要后不是说你有儿女，是你后面有没有继承人，啊，有没有这个道德的继承人，啊，这个伦理的继承人呢，跟这个事业的继承人，如果儿女再多不能继承啊， 这个是错误的啊。所以他这个太太的任务非常重大啊，他要教育底下一代。你家里面有人才出来，那这是他的功劳啊。所以这个责任呢，比男子在外面谋生还要重要。
We mentioned before there are five relationships, human relationships. The first one is the relationship between parents and children, and then the second important relationship and the differences is between husbands and wives. They should have their distinct responsibilities and obligations to a family.Family is the core unit of our society. Therefore, both husbands and wives bear different responsibilities. And those responsibilities are, one of the couple has to generate income for the family so they can maintain a certain standard of living. And then another responsibility is to make sure that the children receive a good family education. Because when they have children, the most important thing is that when their children grow up, they can inherit what the family tradition is passed on, which is basically a moral and ethical person. So therefore,So if the wife is the person in the family that's responsible of raising the children, then actually her merits in the family is really bigger and higher than the husband's, if the husband is the one who's generating the income.
所以中国的一个教育是在家庭啊，那么小孩从出生大概到三岁呀，就很懂事，啊，他没有看到不善的，没有听到不善的，啊，所以他都能变成一个善人，变成一个好人。所以家里有好人，社会有好人，国家有好人，世界有好人呢。好人是教出来的呀。
So the Chinese education centered on the family education, because since a child is born up to 3 years old, when the child starts to understand his or her external environment, if the child, what the child sees is all good, and the child doesn't see any evil, naturally the child, when the child grows up,he will be a good person. So therefore, a good person, of course, our self-nature is good, but mainly all children need to be taught and be guided to know how to be a good person.
今天我们看到整个世界都弥漫着动荡不安，啊，人人都生活在恐怖之中，啊，这个原因是什么？是从哪里来的呢？是我们的不善的教导，啊，才产生这样的效果啊。那么中国教育啊，诸位也是细细看中国的历史，中国人从来没有侵略过邻近的国家。没有发动过侵略别人的战争，这个道理在哪里呢？道理就在从小接受仁爱的教育，啊，与一切，这个不同的国家、不同的族群啊、不同的文化都能够和睦相处，啊，所以现在这个世界迫切需要这样的教育。
So today, when we look at the whole world, the whole world is in a great turmoil. A lot of people they are living in the terrorist conditions. They were afraid of terrorist actions. Now, where do all those terrorist actions come from? All the bad things come from? From education that is about evil and not about good. In Chinese education, in China's history, Chinese has never attacked anyone or any country. Well, that's because from very little, Chinese were educated and received the moral values education in the past. And all the children were taught that it is most important that they should learn how to communicate with other people and to live with other people in harmony.
所以学校教育是家庭教育的延续，社会教育是知识能力的扩充，宗教教育才达到究竟圆满，让你彻底了解宇宙人生的真相。啊，这个教育是一贯的。
Therefore, the education that we receive from educational institutions, they are really stem from the family education.And this education, and then going into societies, we are educated, we see education as well there. And then, of course, religious education is what makes the education perfect.
那么最近，我有一点时间，我看中国近代的就是清朝时候300年前看这个康熙、雍正、乾隆这三代差不多是有100多年这个康熙61年雍正13年，乾隆60年他后面有4年的太上皇，这是清朝最盛的一个时期我看到他们这些帝王，他不是天天开会，他是天天上课，他请这个儒家、道家、佛家，这个三教，这个这是有德行的有学问的这一些大德，在宫廷里面上课，皇帝带着文武百官天天听课，这很了不起的一个做法，就重视这个。传统教育，那我现在看的是，就看他们宫廷里面上课的讲义，到底这宫廷里这些老师们讲的什么东西，他学的什么东西，那么这些东西对于政治对于整个社会产生什么样的影响，让我们看到的是确实，感触非常之深，对于这些帝王敬佩的五体投地。
Just recently, in my spare time, I was reading the history or the things that took place in the Qing Dynasty. Basically, the Emperor Kangxi, Yongzheng, Qianlong.And during those three emperors, they lasted over 100 years. And they are the strongest and the most prosperous period during the Qing Dynasty. And I found out that the reason that they were prosperous and they were doing well, they weren't having meetings or conferences every day. But instead, including the emperor and all his officials, Actually, they go to classes every day. What they learn is the three teachings in China, basically Confucianism, Taoism, and Buddhism. They were all encouraged to study and to learn more every day. And I admire them a great deal because apparently they were all followers of Chinese old traditional education. And so I was very curious. So I looked into their studies and tried to find out what the teachers were teaching in the palace. And after I see all the documents, recorded documents of their lessons, I was, you know, I respected them even more.
冲突需要化解，不能够对立。啊，我这次到美国，啊，看到布什总统，啊，我参加他的这个宴会，啊，也是接受他的邀请，几乎除了总统、副总统之外，连他的参议员。进入会场啊，都像严格的检查，啊，要脱鞋子，腰带都要拉出来。我说这个太苦，这种生活太苦了，啊，这在20年前在美国，从美国是最自由的地方，我们进出的时候从行李没检查过，啊，送客的时候都能送到飞机门口，甚至送到飞机里面替我放行李。你看现在变成这个样子，这就是这恐怖分子怎么产生的啊！所以恐怖不能对立，啊，对立了永远不能解决问题，一定要化解，和平要用爱的教育，爱人就不会害人，啊，所以一定要提倡啊伦理道德爱的教育啊，我们才能把整个社会啊重新带向和谐。
So all the conflicts and confrontations of our world, they need to be resolved. We should not expand this conflict and confrontation or having people going against each other. Recently, I had the opportunity of being in the United States.And when I was there, I had the honor to meet President Bush. And I was invited to his banquets. And as I was there, I was observing that except the president and the vice president, everyone else, they all had to go through very close checking points. All the guests, even belts, they have to take it off and to be examined and tested. And I thought many years ago, I remember that United States is the freest country in the world. I remember when I was getting on a plane.Many years ago, actually the visitors were allowed to go into the airport. They actually helped me to put the luggage onto the compartments. But because of the terrorist actions that has been taking place recently, all this has changed. And I just wondered why all this is happening.The essence is, I think the reason is that we need to love people. Because only when we love people, we will not harm them. And only through love can we bring our world back onto the course of peace.
我们从事于和平工作的人 我常常想着，如果我们能够每一天观察自己的身体，就会开智慧。宇宙是一体，地球是一个，就像我们的身体一样。我们身体外面呢有眼耳鼻舌，里面有五脏六腑啊，就像啊不同的国家、不同的族群、不同的文化、不同的宗教，一个身体啊。那中国是眼睛啊，美国是耳朵啊，这是如果说是我眼睛第一，耳朵坏了，耳朵不行了，其他器官不行了，你就不健康了。严重的时候他病死了，所以观察清楚之后啊，那我们的心量可以拓开，在这个地球上，每一个国家都第一，每一个族群都第一，每一个文化都第一，每一个宗教都第一，没有第二的，这个地球健康了，只是如果发生有第一、第二的时候，这个问题。冲突矛盾必然产生，所以今天由于科技的发达，交通便捷，地球真的变成地球村了，住在地球上都是一家人，一家人应当和睦相处，应当要包容，应当彼此要尊重，要敬爱，要互助合作，我们要推动这样的教育。
All of us here, we are all in the field of peace builders, trying to make peace. If we observe our own physical body very carefully, that we will realize that the universe is all of one body. So is the planet Earth.It is like the, if you observe our own body, our eyes, our ears, our nose, our mouth, our tongue, they are just like the different nationalities, races, and religions of our world. If United States is the eyes, and the different countriesrepresented by different organs of our body. If one of the organs is not working or functioning properly, if the situation gets very serious, the body probably dies. Therefore, we should look at all the nationalities, religions, and races as number one. Only whenall the different fractions of our world are number one, where we have a healthy planet. If there is a number one or number two, then conflicts and dilemmas will occur and take place. So we are all one family on this planet Earth. We need to learn how to.Respect each other, love each other, and to work together, and cooperate together, and to live in harmony.
那么在这个几天当中，我们有这么好的这些议题，我相信诸位大德一定都有非常高明的这个建议希望我们做出成绩来。那么这几天呢，我们祝福诸位在此地身体健康生活能够过得很愉快我非常感谢这个学校的安排我也感谢这个诸位从远地来到澳洲我们非常欢喜聚集在一堂来从事于这个化解冲突促进和平的这个工作是很神圣的一个任务非常感谢大家
For the next few days, with all the distinguished participants here, and the wonderful and also questions that have been raised to be discussed in this symposium, I am sure that you all and we can find possibly a solution to the problems. And here I would like to wish everybody good health and have a pleasant stay in Brisbane. And I realize that you are all, some of you come from very far places, and we are all gathered here today, was trying to make, to solve all the problems that have been, trying to solve the problems that have been raised, and this is indeed a sacred work. Thank you very much.
非常感谢这一次的开会与会的诸位真正是和平的使者。
I'm very appreciative for all the participants who come to the symposium.
自从去年呢，我在亚特兰大参加这个会议之后我们感到每一次会议都没有办法落实，就是感到非常的遗憾。
Because since last year, he attended the symposium in Adelaide and several other times, and he felt that each time he didn't really see the final conclusion or the solution were being practiced or put into practice. So he was feeling a little bit disappointed.
所以在这一年多，我们很认真、很努力我们建了一个多元文化中心，那么也正在筹备办一个学校，就像大家建议所说的，我们从幼稚园一直办到大学。
Therefore, for the past year, he has built a multicultural center.And also a school, and he intends to the level of school starts from the kindergarten all the way to the university level.
那我们的中心呢？现在已经建筑的差不多了，现在是内部装修，预定11月底完工。我们11月工作人员就可以住进去，明年初呢，我们就开始招生了。
And then this center.By the October, the construction should be complete. By November, the personnel will be able to move into the structure. And then starting next January, they will start having students going to accepting applications from students.
我们招生的对象是以幼稚园的老师、小学老师、初中老师为对象，这个课程的内容都是伦理道德的教育。我想，我们这次会议大家所提供的，可以全部在这个学校里边落实。
And then the application that he's looking for will be starting from teachers in the kindergarten, elementary school, high school, and then based on the category of classes would be on moral values education.
我们的目标是希望这个中心所在的这个小镇大概有20万人的样子，使我们这个小镇呢完全落实伦理道德教育。
And then the little town, the school is situated. Only about 200,000 people. He was hoping that by establishing this school, that he will be able to put the practice of moral values education.
我想我们一定要做一个模型，做一个这个榜样 啊，能够给全世界爱好和平的人呢去看到，他才会感动。我们怎么样说了，这个都是有多少层的隔阂，一定要做出来给人看，把诸位这么好的这个意见通通做出来给世间人看。
And he said, it's an absolute necessity that he puts all the valuable recommendation that he received today during this symposium, he's going to put it into practice into his school. And so he says it has to be, people have to actually see the school and its effects and the results will people be finally touched.By what this type of education can do for the world and for the people.
那么我们自己也有自己的卫星电视，有自己的这个网络啊，所以我们这一些和平使者，我们不但呢要把你们的东西啊放在网络上，放在卫星电视上传播，而且将来啊很有必要要请你们到我们中心担任教授。
And then he said, definitely, since we have our own satellite TV and internet, he intends to put the recommendations that he received this afternoon, he's going to broadcast it onto the satellite TV and also the internet.
我非常感谢，希望我们能够保持联系，明年诸位就能看到今天开会的成果。
And he's very appreciative of what the results of this symposium. And by next year, you will see the results of the start of that school. And by that time, he was hoping that maybe that you will be a teacher, invited as a teacher in that school and come and visit the school as well.
非常感谢大家，非常感谢，非常感谢，也感谢学校啊，感谢学校，感谢这个联合国的支持。
And he was very appreciative for all your past support and support at Griffith University and the Motivate Center. Thank you very much.
谢谢。